So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and I'm here to discuss with you all some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. All right, so let's begin with the very first question, which is about Northeast Venture Fund. Okay, it is about Northeast Venture Fund. So you have to consider these three statements 1, 2, 3 about the Northeast Venture Fund, and you have to identify the correct statement. Okay, so now guys, the question is why we are discussing about this Northeast Venture Fund. So recently the Minister for Development of Northeastern Region, who is Dr. Jitendra Singh, has said that a lot of entrepreneurs and startups are attracting towards this Northeast Venture Fund and it is performing exceptionally well. So that is why we are discussing it. And let's talk about this venture fund in more detail. So its objective is to encourage entrepreneurs and startups from the Northeast region and basically to empower those entrepreneurs and startups by providing funding in their ideas. Okay, it was launched in the year 2017 with a total corpus of rupees 100 crore ka iska total corpus tha. And who is the sponsor? It's Northeastern Development Finance Corporation Limited, in short is NEDFD. Okay, and talking more about it, so investment manager is NEDFI Venture Capital Limited, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of NEDFI. And also investment size is how much? The minimum investment size required is how much? Rupees 25 lakh, while the maximum investment which can be done through this fund is how much? Rupees 10 crores. Okay, so minimum and maximum investment, both you have to remember. So these are some basic information guys about this fund, and that's very important because Government of India is working very hardly towards the development of Northeast region. So you have to remember everything about the Northeastern region. So Northeast Venture Fund was launched in the year 2017 with a corpus of rupees 100 crore by the Ministry of Development of Northeastern region, and it has the objective to empower the entrepreneurs and startup from the Northeastern area. Okay, and minimum investment required is how much? Rupees 25 lakhs, while maximum investment is how much? Rupees 10 crore. Okay, so now let's come back to the question. So you have to identify the correct statement. It was launched in the year 2014. No, it was not launched in 2014. It was 2017 when it was launched. Its total corpus is rupees 1000 crore. So is that 1000 crore? No, that's 100 crores. Okay, and minimum investment size is rupees 50 lakh. No, that is not 50 lakh guys, that's how much? 25 lakh. So which means this statement is also incorrect. Minimum investment size is 25 lakh, while maximum is how much? Rupees 10 crore. Which means all the statements are incorrect here, and we have to identify the correct statement. Therefore, option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. Okay, and now let's move on to question number 2. So guys, question number 2 and 3 are based on the National Energy Conservation Awards 2020. It was the 30th edition. Okay, it was the 30th edition of National Energy Conservation Awards 2020. So let's first discuss about these awards. So Ministry of Power, which is currently headed by Mr. R.K. Singh, and he is also the Minister of New and Renewable Energy. Mr. R.K. Singh, Lok Sabha constituency is Ara in Bihar. Okay, so Ministry of Power in association with Bureau of Energy Efficiency has organized the 30th edition of National Energy Conservation Awards 2020. And ye award kyun diye jaate hain? To recognize the efforts of industries, to recognize the efforts of organizations, institutions in the field of energy sector. Okay, energy sector mein agar koi institution, agar koi organization, agar koi body koi achha kaam karta hai, to unko recognize karne ke liye, unke efforts ko recognize karne ke liye ye awards diye jaate hain by the Ministry of Power in association with Bureau of Energy Efficiency. Okay, and talking about the categories, so these are the 5 categories under which these awards are given. Number 1 is industry, then we have transport, institution, building and appliance of the year. And guys, there are various other sub categories also, and for all the sub categories you don't have to remember the winners. So what we will do is we will do only the important winners. All right, so let's talk about the winners then. So first of all, in the industry category, in the industry categories guys, there are various subcategories, but these are some important subcategories which we are going to discuss. Number 1 is dairy. So in the dairy subcategory, first prize has been given to Heritage Foods Limited in Chittoor. Okay, While for the second prize, it's again Heritage Foods Limited, but from Vishakhapatnam. Then certificate of merit has been given to again Heritage Foods Limited from Bengaluru. All right. And petroleum refinery ka subcategory mein, the first prize has been given to IOCL Paradeep. While second prize kisi ko nahi mila, then talking about the certificate of merit, it's BPCL Kochi Refinery. Okay. And talking about the automobiles, so Tata Motors ko automobiles mein first prize mila tha and in the subcategory of industry. All right. And Tata Motors current chairperson is Mr. N. Chandrasekharan. And moving ahead to the transport category. So in the transport category, there is one subcategory which is known as zonal railways. And remember one thing guys here, the maximum number of awards has been given to the Indian Railways. Indian Railways ko sabse zyada number of awards mile hain in these National Energy Conservation Awards. And how many awards? 13. 13 awards mile hain Indian Railways ko in various categories and subcategories. And talking about this category, zonal railway, so first prize has been given to the Western Railway, second prize Eastern Railway, while certificate of merit has been given to Northeastern Railway. All right. And institution ki baat kar le, to there is one important subcategory which is municipality. So Chandigarh municipality has got the first prize, while certificate of merit has been given to NDMC, which is New Delhi Municipal Corporation. And moving ahead, so guys, these are some important winners that you have to remember. And as I told you that there are a lot of winners, there are a lot of subcategories which are not important for the exam. You just have to remember these subcategories and their respective winners. All right. And now moving ahead. So during the event, during the award ceremony, there was one portal also that was launched, which is known as Saathi portal. And you should remember the full form of Saathi: state wise action on annual targets on and headways on energy efficiency. State wise actions on annual targets and headways on energy efficiency is the full form of Saathi. And what is the objective of launching this portal? So it will, guys, facilitate real time monitoring of the progress of the work which are undergoing in the energy sector. Energy sector mein jo bhi efficient work ho raha hai, uski monitoring rakhi jayegi through this portal, which is known as Saathi portal. This portal was also launched during the event. All right. And now let's come back to question number 2 and 3. So I hope guys you can easily answer the question. Now Ministry of Power has organized 38th edition of National Energy Conservation Awards in association with DASH. So which you have to fill this gap. So this organization guys is what? Option B, Bureau of Energy Efficiency. So Bureau of Energy Efficiency, talking about it more, it was established in the year 2002 under the Energy Conservation Act. There is one act which is known as Energy Conservation Act of 2001. Energy Conservation Act 2001 mein isko establish kiya tha, and of course it is a statutory body and it has the objective, it has the mandate to provide support in policy framing and in the strategy framing related to the energy sector. Energy sector mein jo bhi policy framing or strategy banai jati hai, usme support provide karana to the government of India is the mandate of Bureau of Energy Efficiency. Alright, and Mr. Abhay Bakre is the current Director General of Bureau of Energy Efficiency. And moving ahead to question number 3. So you have to consider these statements regarding winners of the National Energy Conservation Awards, and you have to identify the incorrect statements here. So incorrect statement identify karna hai. So let's talk about the very first statement. In the industry petroleum refinery category, IOCL Paradeep is the winner. Yes, this is absolutely correct. IOCL Paradeep was the winner, while BPCL Kochi has received the Certificate of Merit Award. In automobile category, first prize has been given to Tata Motors. Absolutely correct. And Indian Railways has won maximum number of events at the event. So as I told you, Indian Railways has got the maximum number of awards, that is 13. So this statement is also correct. And you have to identify the incorrect statement, which means option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. And guys, remember one more thing also, that the first edition of National Energy Conservation Award was held in the year 1991. Pehla edition kab hua tha? 1991 mein, and this was the 30th edition of these awards. And now let's move on to question number 4. For which sector Union Home Minister has inaugurated a single window clearance system web portal? So for there is one sector for which this single window clearance system web portal has been launched by Union Home Minister Mota Bhai. So we have to tell the name of that sector. So guys, this sector, let me tell you the answer first. This sector is coal sector. सो व्हाट आर द बेनिफिट्स? ये कोल सेक्टर में बेसिकली एक सिंगल विंडो क्लियरेंस सिस्टम है, जो भी कमर्शियल कोल माइनिंग का जो ऑक्शन होता है उसके लिए जो भी क्लियरेंस चाहिए होती है दैट कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड थ्रू दिस वेब पोर्टल. ओके, दिस वेब पोर्टल विल फैसिलिटेट द ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस रिफॉर्म्स, इट विल फैसिलिटेट द ईजी यू नो कमर्शियल माइनिंग ऑक्शन प्रोसेस, इट विल फैसिलिटेट द स्मॉल एंड मीडियम एंटरप्राइजेस सो दैट दे कैन ईजिली गेट द कोल. ओके, सो देर आर वेरियस बेनिफिट्स लाइक it will give a boost to the commercial coal mining auctions, it will facilitate small and medium enterprises to receive the coal supplies easily, it will boost the transparency and ease of doing business reforms, and of course since it is making the commercial coal mining auctions process easy, so it will lead to the employment generation, and it is expected that it will create approximately 70,000 jobs in the coal mining sector. All right, so therefore the correct answer is what, option C, coal sector and ministry of coals and mines is headed by Mr. Prahlad Joshi and he is also the minister of parliamentary affairs. His Lok Sabha constituency is Dharwad in Karnataka, and don't confuse Mr. Prahlad Joshi with Prahlad Singh Patel. He is the minister of Prahlad Singh Patel guys is the minister of tourism, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Damoh. All right, so don't confuse between Prahlad Singh Patel and Prahlad Joshi. So that's it for the session guys. I hope all the four questions are clear, and these were the four questions today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.